Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Wybot. Welcome back to Civilization 6. I've been having some trouble bringing this one to you, quite frankly. I had some bad luck with my first attempt. The second attempt, I got 3 episodes in before I realized that I hadn't done a sound check and the whole damn thing was muted. So this is gonna be try number 3, third time's a charm, I believe. And just to make it more interesting, we're throwing some mods in there. We're throwing in what I believe is Chow's Quick UI mod. I think it encompasses a bunch of stuff now, so we're gonna check that out. Yeah, we're checking it out the first time on the Let's Play, because why not? What could possibly go wrong? And of course, we're playing as Australia, the latest civilization here. So I'm just gonna really quickly go over their abilities. We'll get more in depth into them once the game starts. Anyway, John Curtin's personal ability, he is the Prime Minister of Australia during World War II, and his ability is Citadel of Civilization, which if someone declares a war on you for 10 turns, then, or for 10 turns after they declare a war on you, you get a 100% production boost. If you liberate a city in the past 20 turns, then you'll get a 100% production boost as well. So, late game, it may actually be a good strategy to go out there and liberate some city-states. I believe you can probably just take them right over after. So, we will be testing that in this game. Oh yes. We'll be liberating, like, Zanzibar from the Aztecs, and then immediately just take it over. See if it still works. Anyway, Australia's normal ability, the default ability for Australia, is Land Down Under. Plus 3 housing when you're on a coastal city. This will stack with fresh water. So if you've got a river, then you're going to have some massively huge cities without having to do anything. Also, more importantly, you will get bonus yields from... well, you'll get yields, period. You don't usually get anything from... tiles with charming or breathtaking appeal, but in this case you will get +2 of the respective yields from campuses, commercial hubs, holy sites, and theater squares in charming appeal tiles. So you get +2 of whatever yield there, and +4 in breathtaking appeal tiles. So here's the thing. Mountains can make breathtaking appeal. So if you've got an area that has, like, I don't know, 4 mountains or so around it, then that tile's probably going to be breathtaking appeal already. So you're going to get +4, plus the 4 science from those mountains, so you automatically get an 8 science campus. So I think that probably puts Australia into the, it's a science civ category here. But, yeah, we'll see. Anyway, let's get on to the next one here. The next one, their unique unit is kind of meh, but it makes up for it. I guess it has to be something that's not as good in here, the Digger. So it's Australia's unique modern era unit, replaces infantry. It has +5 combat strength when fighting on the coast, or +10 combat strength when fighting on the coast, and +5 combat strength when fighting in neutral or foreign territory. So that's somewhat good. It's a little late in the game. The Outback Station, it is Australia's unique improvement, and it provides +1 food, +1 production just to whatever tile it is. So on its own, it's a pretty good improvement. But it gets bonuses, additional production, and food as you advance through the tech and civic tree. I believe steam power will give you a bonus to production, and I think rapid deployment civic gives you a bonus to food. Oh, and also you get bonus +1 food for each adjacent pasture. So, yeah, these things are pretty friggin' good in my opinion. So, we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna get started. And we're gonna see if the mod completely destroys everything.
From the first stirrings of life beneath water, to the great beasts of the Stone Age, to man taking his first upright steps, you have come far. Now begins your greatest quest. From this early cradle of civilization on towards the stars. Prime Minister Curtin, you will lead Australia through challenge after challenge, and your people will emerge all the stronger for it. Others will seek friendship for your strength. If these friends prove loyal, your might and protection will carry you far. But stay vigilant, for aggression is not your natural course.
Okay. I think I'm actually just gonna... Yeah, no, I'm not gonna throw a pause on here. I'm just gonna note the time here. We're gonna try something differently today. I'm gonna time this based on the in-game clock. What could possibly go wrong there, hmm? Alright, and my computer's just going to take a little bit of time here to load things up. Might be a bit longer because of the mods. We'll see. Oh, and we are playing on Deity, of course. We're playing on a Pangaea map because I think that's the best way of doing things. The Outback station's a really good improvement, and I just want to cover large areas with it. And hopefully we'll be lucky enough to get a coastal start. I believe Australia has a coastal bias. So, we'll see. This might be a better civilization to play on continents, but I've had some good luck with, well, in quotations, good luck with Pangaea maps recently. Ugh. The hell? Alright. Okay, well, this is... The UI mod seems to be working. Let's go ahead and let's take a look at all the... Yes, indeed, we have some wonderful new lenses. So we have the Builder Lens. None of these appear to be working yet. Oh, that's interesting. So that's kind of bugging out there a little. Ah, there's a lens for a goodie hat. That's very nice. Anyway, I'm trying to... Let's see if we can get the... Yep, it works. Cool. Where do we want to put our city? I mean, this is on frickin' tundra. What about appeal? I'm really not a big fan of this start location, so I'm thinking... But that's three turns away. I'm not ready to sacrifice three fucking turns on this. Ugh. Alright. We'll settle on spot then, simply because we have no better option. Well, we might have, but... Yeah. Alright. Anyway, it's gonna take me a sec to get used to this. All sorts of wonderful information here, though. Luxuries, entertainment. So entertainment from the palace, I guess. Let's go ahead and get a scout out. Oh, we can do a production queue, of course. That is wonderful. We'll throw the monument in there. We'll throw a builder in there. Warrior, we can't do a settler yet, of course. Then we can just drag the way we could with the Civ 5 mod. That is very nice. I'm a big fan of this. Yeah, it looks good. That's going to help me optimize my play a lot. This is available on the Steam Workshop, by the way. Let's see here. Can I get the... Yeah, it's Chow's Quick UI mod is what I'm using here. So it's on the Steam Workshop. It is CQUI. Is just search that and it'll come up. If you want to try it out yourself. Let's go ahead and grab Animal Husbandry to start off with. And of course, we have no choice there. We're doing Codal Laws, whether we like it or not. And... Oop. Yeah, go pop the goody hut, please. So 7 turns, that's going to grow.
Okay.
And what of our worker here? Oh, okay, that's nice. So we just mouse over the city and we get... It's not very well done, but... Yeah, it's pretty cool. Cool. So that's the highest production tile possible. What's this 13 here mean? Oh, it's 13 combat strength. Or is it? Nice. So mouse over the city and you get all the resources. That could clean things up for a let's play. Ooh, and we get all kinds of goodies. Very happy about that. It's Leventa. I think we might actually take these guys out. Get a new city early on. We'll take a look at it. Ooh. Assuming we don't have to deal with these clowns first.
Reconnaissance units like scouts are unique in that they can gain experience.
Cool, thank you. I'm not sure what I think about this larger mini-map here. It's a little too big. And we found Jakarta as well. All kinds of stuff chilling out in the tundra with us here. So our city grows in 9 turns. I think we actually want to get that city to grow just a little faster, so we're gonna take that off and we're gonna focus on the sheep. Lock those boys in. Pop the goody hut. Jakarta's in the middle of the godforsaken tundra. Another goody hut. Nice.
If there are no dogs in heaven, then when I die, I want to go where they went.
Okay, we didn't get any pop-up for that. Interesting. Oh, well, what do we need for this? We need irrigation. All right. Let's start chipping away at archery, I think. Sure. For now, you pull back. Oh, we got a free scout. Cool. Got here. Gonna have you guys explore to the north.
Gilgamesh!
Can you be my friend, Gilgamesh? Please don't have a, oh, bad Tibra. We better find some other stuff nice and quick. Let's send him a delegation, get some positive. Gilgamesh has received your tributes and your envoys. He will let them enter Uruk. Gilgamesh talks in the third person! He has very negative impressions of us. First impressions of us. Interesting. Wow, this guy has really bushy eyebrows right there. Alright, let's keep going. Alright, this guy... Actually, you know what? You can fortify up, and they can't really do jack. Gilgamesh pretty soon is going to get those nasty war carts here. Your delegation is most welcome, Gilgamesh. We want to be friends with you. Please, let us be friends. We'll probably plop a city right down there and annoy you, but please, let us be friends. Actually, we may try not to annoy you. We'll see.
Alright, we'll put that guy back now.
Discovered a new continent, the continent of Ur. Apparently we're on South America. Okay. Canterbury's working the good tiles there. Okay, good. Not a lot of food producing tiles though, unfortunately. Lots and lots of wonderful hills.
Enacting
we lost
our
damn warrior. Alright, let's grab discipline so we can get a leg up on those stupid barbarians. And we'll grab God King as usual so we can get a Pantheon up. And we got a boost for both of these. That must be Goody Hut related. Very nice. Let's get this up so we can get foreign trait. Wow. That was surprisingly fast. Alright, we're gonna have all kinds of goodies here then. Religious settlement, fertility rites, God of the Forge. God of the Forge is just temporary though, God of the Sea. It could be good, but probably won't be. Monument to the Gods, once again temporary. Lady of the Reeds and Marshes, I hardly ever get that one. That'd be good for this. We've got a few marshes around. God of Craftsmanship. Over plus one production for mines over strategic resources. Well, we don't know where the strategic resources are yet. I think I'm probably going to go for Divine Spark. It's what I normally go for. It's a good safe bet. This dude's gonna pull back. Hey. Alright, and we're gonna go back into the city here and... Where's the build queue? There we go. Yeah, so we're actually gonna add a slinger to the queue here. No, come on. Slinger on top. I know the builder just has one turn left, but we need a slinger now. Japan.
いかがある?
You're a little bit glitchy. It's an honor to meet you. Sure, let's exchange information about our capitals. And while we're at it, before we get screwed over, let's send a delegation to make sure we have good relations here. Really negative first impressions from both of them. More obvious numbers here. Wonder if it's going to remind me about the, No, it doesn't look like it's reminding me yet, but I should drop it and go for mining. So that's the city of Uruk right there. That's Bad Tibra. That's another goody hut. And that's me running into my city to be safe. Accept their delegation. So Gilgamesh is producing 13 science. Hojo's producing 7. Yeah, Gilgamesh is spamming his unique improvement, as he should. We got a boost to irrigation from the Goody Hut. Very nice. Next turn. Try to get a few more heals out of my warrior. Put him over here now. Cross the river there. Oh, we got a... We must have found a city-state. We did indeed. We found the city-state of Kabul. Perfect. Not too far away from us either. Oh, and Gilgamesh is attacking the barbarians. That's helpful, Gilgamesh. Ooh.
Yeah, I think we want to pull this guy back a bit more.
In Canberra, we need to adjust our stuff again. Monument down, warrior up. Keep exploring. We should be able to fight this off fairly well with a that dude in the capital there.
We'll fortify till healed.
We'll attack and kill this guy. And we've advanced considerably in archery. And one turn until we can upgrade the slinger to an archer. We'll see just what the barbarians do here, whether they'll run their faces into the city or what. Not yet.
I shot an arrow into the air. It fell to earth. I knew not where.
Yeah, it's a little annoying I don't get the pop-ups here. Let's upgrade him right away. I suppose we could have delayed that and maybe gotten out a few more slingers and then upgraded them. Because it's... I believe that's the most optimal way to do it. Anyway, this guy, he's just gonna sit. He's gonna heal. And that'll be good. Next turn. You go exploring around Kabul. And our archer. Let's go ahead and just kill that guy. We got a boost for bronze working. Perfect. You just chill there for now. Chill there. Tank some damage. And we found the city of Zanzibar. Perfect.
Yeah, he's still in bad shape if he tries to attack. So our warrior is going to move out.
Our archer is going to damage this guy. And we're actually going to delay the monument yet again. In favor of a builder. Probably once again in favor of a settler. This is getting a little difficult to manage here. Come on, no. Why does it keep doing this? There we go. This is a breathtaking tile as well.
Who deserves more credit than the wife of a coal miner?
Alright, we got coal mining. Yeah, we got mining, period. Let's grab irrigation. That apparently needs pottery. We don't have pottery yet. Alright, wow, look at that. Nice big number that says 3. It's highlighting the tiles. I should... improve. Very good, very good. Kill that guy. Perfect. Run into that dude.
Run into this dude. And finally, take that guy out.
Next turn.
It's making it painfully obvious here that we have promotions, which is good. It's not actually that painful at all. Alright. Let's go ahead and grab that. We've got a culture bomb to boot. So plus 5, it's breathtaking appeal. That will give us plus 4 culture or plus 4 science, and it'll probably give us like plus 6 gold if we put a trade hub down there. So we'll probably just drop a campus down there. We do want to go heavy culture with Australia, though.
Every nation lives by exchanging.
Okay. It's getting very, very jarring not seeing the pop-ups for that. Anyway, we can scrap God King. We can throw this in. Urban planning. We'll confirm that. 3 turns until our settler is done. Let's keep exploring. Ooh, horses up there. Very nice. We need to explore more over here. Where's our other scout? He's probably somewhere around here, I'll bet. Yeah, so one's here, one's on his way back. Okay. Very good. Cross the river. Actually, have you cross the river here, and then you'll fortify until healed. We've got one spot for trade, for a trade route. That'll be what we build immediately after. And then we'll have to decide whether we want to go here. Probably we'll head out over here, grab the sheep so we can get some outback stations around it later on. For now, we're going to build a mine. You move up, you fortify until healed. You move out. You keep going. Ah, it's got our military strength. Very good. That is super helpful. Gandhi! You're pretty chill. It's an honor to meet you, Gandhi. We'd love to sample your hospitality. Oh, that's your capital right there. Very nice. Can we get an embassy with you before you, Aw, you like my gifts. That's very nice. Let's be friends. I just want to be friends with everybody. Yeah. Let's just be friends with everybody this game. I'm actually kind of curious to see who's gonna stick the knife in my back first. My money's on Gilgamesh, but we'll see. Actually, it reminds me, just in case it is Gilgamesh. Hello, Steam screen. I do not want that. Or cart. Because there's a space. There's actually a hyphen. What sort of combat strength? 30! Yeah, that's like a baby horseman. That could be a problem. Also, what's a problem? No horses near me. And we don't know about iron either. Alright, so settler. It's automatically got the thing on there. Yeah, okay. So it's a city overlap. Well, let's get this guy out.
I think we'll go over there. We'll hope that Gilgamesh doesn't have too many war carts up and running. And sure, we'll let the bloody monument finish. We need the extra culture. Let's take a look here at what's going on. So Gilgamesh is producing minimal culture. We're producing even less. These guys are producing a good amount. I'm gonna escort that settler. And we're just gonna put that guy to sleep on that tile for now. And that may have not been the best move. Oh well. No, we don't want to go to war with Gandhi, so we'll just go around. Absolutely, Gandhi. Come, see me, be friends with me. Oh, okay. So we actually mouse over the unhappy screen.
No man ever wetted clay up and then left it. As if there would be bricks by chance and fortune.
So different governments, first impressions. Friendly meeting, we sent them a delegation, first impressions. So Japan is solidly neutral towards us. Our relationship's minus two. Ah, it tallies them. Perfect. That is super useful. It's just one of those little quality of life improvements. Get this guy out. And we'll slowly work towards clearing that out. What sort of appeal do these have? This is a breathtaking tile, apparently. What do we got here? Charming. 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 Breathtaking. Interesting. So in theory, we might actually be able to get a crappy snow city to be viable, just in terms of yields from the whatever district we have there. District or districts we have there. Oh, that's interesting. That's probably telling me more information than it should. That that guy has a promotion due, but he hasn't used it yet. Samaria has expanded with the new city of Sippar. Looks like it's over there to the east. Very good for them. Hope they don't mind that I am settling just west of their capital. They probably will. So that's a charming tile that... This should be kind of breathtaking once I find it. So we're actually going to go up here. That's a breathtaking tile, so it's a good area for... It's a very good spot for a campus. What do we want to do here? I think we want to settle across the river, just over on this tile right here. I think that would be good. Let's go over 6 overlap. Okay. So we'd be just at the edge of the overlap area. Okay. Well, we'll see. The overlap's not as good as it used to be. Oh, horses down here, so that's a good spot for a city. Or just take Leventa and buy up tiles. That works as well. Horsemen are the most effective way of countering Gilgamesh, though. And we won't have any particular use for Leventa. Alright, yeah, let's cross the river. Let's settle over on this side. I like that better. We've got a second settler out. Well, we'll get a second settler queued up, actually. I want to get some more... I want more archers. So we'll get a couple of those guys out.
Yosemite Valley to me is always a sunrise, a glitter of green and golden one.
Wonderful. So that would give us a massive holy site right there. Well, we're definitely settling the city here. There's no question. How is the appeal anything less than charming around the natural wonder like that? Anyway, let's build a city up. So we've got Newcastle right there on the river. There's a lot of hills, so we'll go for the Alpine promotion on our scout. Go ahead and start building an archer here, just in case we need him for self-defense. No doubt we'll get a message from Gilgamesh bitching about us settling near him. Which, I'm sorry we started near you. There's nothing we can really do about it. And we will apologize and not settle next to you, or at least we'll say we'll do that, unless you go to war with us. And if that's the case, well, then we'll take your cities. Alright.
Skill without imagination is craftsmanship.
So we're gonna pull this guy back.
Many useful objects, such as wickerwork picnic baskets.
So we've got some really good yields for districts, so we want to just camp districts all around this thing right here. Charming appeal, breathtaking appeal. All these tiles are so good. That's the problem. Well, everything appears to be breathtaking, so we've got a unique luxury here as well. Even though it's tundra, and tundra is shit, I think we're definitely getting city number three right there. It's just too good not to settle for Australia. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab Early Empire. We can probably get that one. Eventually. God, our city hasn't grown at all. Can we boost our food production? No. The answer is no. Alright, this guy should have woken up a while ago. Wake up. Actually, it matters not because we still haven't gotten irrigation. That has been a very long tech. Also, we need a trade route. Considering how crappy our capital is at growing, I think we may actually throw the trade route after the archer. There we go. That's set up. You skip your turn. We don't have that tech yet. Next turn we will. Yeah, so we put a city down here. We have access to horses. We have access
Thousands
to wine.
Thousands have lived without love. Not one without water.
Grab bronze working first, unless we need anything else more. We kind of need writing, actually. We really want to get our technology up here. We're producing 4 science while everybody else is producing 20 to 25. It's not cool. So when we do settle over there, we're going to have to bring some guys in and settle forcefully. Settle with an army at our backs. Somebody built Stonehenge, so they'll get a great profit. Okay, so we're going to send that archer over in that direction. Send the scouts south for now. Clear that encampment. Very good. Next turn.
Seven turns until the city grows.
There is no shame in deterrence.
Yeah, I'm working on my army, Gandhi. My army's not terrible. It's 102 strength. Slightly less than Gilgamesh's. Goody hut. So I think I'm going to buy this tile with the sheep on it, and then that's going to culture bomb and give us a lot more space to work with. It'll allow the city to naturally grow to other things. Get that guy up there. We'll improve the sheep. Got a little more faith. Always good. So interestingly enough, we're actually making more culture than science at the moment. That's not something I often see in my games.
Never again.
Crater Lake. By the grace of- and England, and they're gonna hate our frickin' guts because we're on a different continent. So she is all the way over there. Let's just scroll through these many, many things here. What continent is she on? She is on the continent of Pangaea Ultima. Yeah, she's gonna be really annoyed with us. She's gonna love Gandhi, though. Oh well. Let's try to stave off the irrational hatred. We have low first impressions again. Let's take a look at this. Relationship zero, relationship plus one with Gandhi. He's happy that I'm being peaceful. Minus six with Mr. Gilgamesh here. Different governments, first impressions of me is low. What government is he, actually? He's an oligarchy. Okay, well, we'll work on getting to that. It's gonna take some time, though. Culture bomb the sheeps. Alright, these guys need to move over here. That's where that other barbarian encampment was. Oh, not you! Can I just get a game where you're not in it? That'd be great. Sure, let's... Well, you're far the hell away, which means I'll probably be dealing with you later on. Alright. Well, we got a boost for this guy. There's a lot of hills on this map, so we'll go ahead and we'll give him the Alpine bonus. The Alpine promotion, if you will. Alright, and we're gonna send a trade unit. Ugh. So some of the font here in this new trade screen is not the greatest. Although, on the bright side, we can select what we want here. Highest gold, highest science, highest faith, sort by time to complete route. Let's just send it to Newcastle for now. We got the boost to currency, very good. Send this guy down. Next turn. Yeah, we've got a lot to do in terms of our science. This is very nice, though, to just see what's going on here. Who's doing what with science.
We have recently gained a...
And we've got the tech to build campus district now. So we will get to work on that science. Let's go ahead and do bronze working. That way we can reveal iron, we can get the wonderful encampment, which will be very useful. Be necessary, in fact, because I only think we're going to get one source of horsemen, so we're going to need that. Go ahead and clear out the encampment because we can. Take out the... Well, managed to kill the spearmen. Very nice. Next turn. Alright, go ahead and build a farm on the wheat. Very good. And I think this is probably a good place to drop a cut, guys. I'm sorry, I failed miserably at checking the time. So, yeah, I'm going to drop a cut right here. I hope you're enjoying this Let's Play so far. I'm finding this one to be pretty damn interesting so far. I love the fact that we discovered Yosemite Valley right here. That is looking really good. Even though it's all tundra to the south of it, that's still looking really good. I'm looking forward to dropping districts there. So, thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you're enjoying this video. If you are, feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. You can also do the like thing if you like the video. If you didn't like it, the dislike button's right next to it. And that's going to do it for this one. My name's been Ybot. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to get a campus here before I go. Drop a campus, then a library. Oh my god, it put it in the queue. That is so good. And once again, guys, the mod is Chow's Quick UI mod. It is all consolidated into one beautiful mod now, which works most of the time. So far, it's been pretty good. My name's been Ybot. I'll see you next time.